Hello friends and welcome to Tech Bytes. In today's video, I am going to show you how you can capture Android's apps traffic through Filter Everywhere. I have also made a video previously in which I have shown how can you capture Android's apps traffic with the help of Filter Classic. But as you all know that Filter Everywhere is an updated and improved version of Filter Classic with lots of new features. So I am making this video to show you how you can use Filter Everywhere to capture the Android apps traffic. If you are new to Filter and you don't know how to set up the Filter and how to capture the Android apps traffic, you can watch my previous videos. The link will be available in the description of this video as well as on the I button of this video. So before starting this video, you have to install Filter Everywhere in your system, and for Android apps debugging, I will use the Android emulator MemuPlay. MemuPlay is the most famous free Android emulator which you can install on your system for debugging of Android apps. You can download the MemuPlay from its official website. As you can see on my screen, memuplay.com is the official website from where you can download and install the MemuPlay emulator on your system, and it is completely free of cost. The link will be available in the description of this video. From there, you can straight away go to that link and download and install on your system. The link of Filter Everywhere will also be available in the description of this video, from where you can download Filter Everywhere and get it installed. It is a subscription-based service. You have to pay some fee to use Filter Everywhere, but you can give it a try for 30 days for free. A 30 days trial is given to test it and to run it with full supported features. So you can use it for 30 days without any difficulty. So I have installed both of the softwares in my laptop. As you can see, I have installed Filter Everywhere and I also installed MemuPlay, and this is a completely fresh install. I want to show you everything from scratch so you can set up everything from scratch on your respective system. So first of all, when you launch Filter Everywhere, a screen something like this will be available on your system. First of all, you have to click on HTTPS capture is disabled. You have to enable the HTTPS capture. First of all, click on this link which is saying enable HTTPS now. And after that, a window will show you trust certificate and enable HTTPS. You have to click on trust and enable HTTPS button. You have to also click on the yes button here in the dialog box where it is showing do you want to install the certificate. You have to click on yes, and when you click on yes, the HTTPS is enabled now on your Filter Everywhere. The second thing that you have to do is you have to click on this setting icon on the top right side, the setting gear icon. And here you have to click on the connections tab like this, and here you have to enable allow remote computers to connect. You have to enable this option, allow remote computers to connect. And also note down the port number. You know, on the Filter Everywhere is listening. It is 8866. And click on save. After clicking on save, you can close this dialog box. And now the settings are saved. I have installed Chrome browser on my MemuPlay. By default, when you will launch MemuPlay, it will come as a clean setup. No extra apps are installed there. So you have to install Chrome for yourself because we need Chrome for this demo. And also you have to set up your Gmail account in the Play Store to get the apps installed. And one most important thing, you have to click on this setting icon in the MemuPlay and turn on the root mode. As you can see on my screen, root mode is currently turned on. This should be turned on because root mode is required to perform the coming steps that I am going to show you. And here we have to set the IP of our laptop in the settings of MemuPlay. For that, you have to go to the settings and you have to click on the Wi-Fi icon and then long press on the Wi-Fi icon. You have to long press from your mouse or from your keypad, the left side long press, and you have to select modify network. And here you have to select proxy as manual, and in the proxy host name you have to enter the IP of your system. To get the IP of your system, you can open your command prompt like this cmd, and here you can run a command called ipconfig to get the IP of your system. So as you can see, IPv4 address, this is the IP of my system, and I am entering this IP here, 192.168.0.106. And you have to enter the port number, the same port number on which filter was listening, 8866, and you have to click save. And after that, you have to open Chrome in your memo play, and you have to enter a special URL, which is ipv4.filter:8866, and hit enter. And you can see that filter echo service screen is displayed. If this screen is coming in your memo, in your memo play Chrome browser, then you have done the steps correctly. If this screen is not coming, then you have to check it again. You have done something wrong. So after this screen is getting displayed on your Chrome browser, you have to click on filter root certificate. And here you can give any name and click OK. When you click OK, it will ask you to set up a PIN or password before you can use the credential storage. So click OK. And you can set up any pattern or PIN, whatever you like. I am setting a pattern in my memo play. And done, and certificate is installed. And now one more step you have to do. You have to go to the Play Store, and you have to install an important application which is called Root Certificate Manager. This is the application, get it installed. This application is very important because it will be used to import the certificate from the user credential to the system storage credential. I want to place the certificate in the system root certificate directory, not in the user one. I will show you in detail what I meant to say. Let's wait for it to install. Okay, it will not get installed because we have set up our IP there. So let me remove the IP because else it will not install. And install it again. Okay, app is installed. Now let me show you one thing. Go to settings of your memo play, and in settings I am going to security, and here in trusted credentials you can see that there are two tabs, system and user. Currently the filter root certificate is installed in this user directory and in memo play, but I want to place it under this system tab, and I can't perform this step manually because it will require a lot of manual step, and it is very difficult to do it manually. For that purpose, I have installed this application, Root Certificate Manager. Open it and click on this import button and import filter root, and click on import, and it will put that filter certificate in the system root certificate directory. Let me show you now. In memo play, I again going to security, and here in trusted credentials under system tab, you can see that the filter root certificate is now saved here. Let me show you. Here it is. You can see that on my screen. It is successfully installed under the system root directory. So now we have done all the steps. Now we are ready to capture the traffic. let me put the IP once again, because I have removed my IP. So again, modify network and manual, and I am entering my IP. And the port number is 8866, and click on save. And now you, first of all, let me clear the previous traffic so you can see clearly. Remove all. And now I am opening any app. Suppose I have downloaded and installed booking.com, a booking app which is widely used for making hotels and flights bookings. So I'm opening that, and you can see that my filter everywhere is currently capturing all the traffic from this app. I will also show you by booking one flight, so you can see clearly the traffic is getting captured or not. As you can see, I am hitting the search button, and you can see the traffic is currently getting captured in the filter everywhere. You can see the traffic is getting captured. I can also show you the complete headers and complete response of this. As you can see, I have selected this URL, and here in the right side you can see all the headers, and in the bottom you can see the JSON response that I am getting, the complete response. So that was the complete video showing how to capture Android's app traffic using Filter Everywhere and MemoPlay. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have enjoyed, then hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos. See you in the next video. Have a nice day.